The second week of January can be bye-bye.
Yeah, wait, the week of the 11th, it's just now the 12th.
See, this is why it's been a really long
Archer Day. Number one, Missouri Governor Eric Greitens appears to be digging in for a fight to preserve his political life after admitting to an affair and denying anything more. Greitens has been reaching out to supporters while his attorney has been issuing firm denials to a smattering of accusations. Number two, Illinois' Governor Bruce Rauner. His week-long stay at the Illinois Veterans Home in Quincy has come to an end. We have reaction from veterans who live at the home. One veteran told us that Governor Rauner did not receive any special treatment while he was there. Governor Rauner plans to form a committee in the coming days to talk about the future. Governor Kim Reynolds, she says she wants a water quality bill to be the first piece of legislation she signs as governor. But a senator from Hiawatha says she doesn't think that's feasible because lawmakers disagree on how to fund that bill. Number five, time to start preparing those W-2s. The IRS will start accepting the 2017 federal income tax returns on Monday, January 29th, just a couple weeks away. If you're not an early bird filer, you'll have until Tuesday, April 17th to get your taxes filed. Also this morning, lawmakers and civil rights organizations are pushing back against offensive comments President Trump made about immigrants from Haiti, El Salvador, and countries in Africa. The disparaging remarks came during an Oval Office meeting with lawmakers trying to force an immigration deal. Number six, hope is dimming for the search for survivors in the California mudslides. So far, at least 17 people off from Montecito are dead. More than 40 are still unaccounted for.
And number seven, it is cold and extremely windy. These are wind gusts this morning across the tri-state.